What's up, guys? It's Joe from Joewillsart, and I am here with two of my co-hosts, I guess you could say. One from Express Your Geek over here, Nessie.
Hey, guys.
And one from the last vlog that you saw from me.
Hi, I'm Ashley B. What's up?
There you go. And today we actually had a show in mind, and we were sitting here trying to figure out exactly what we wanted to talk about, and we had so much fun talking about some stuff from way back in the day with the cartoons. We figured we'd just keep the ball rolling and talk about nostalgic movies. So, first nostalgic movie that you can remember that you loved, what was that?
I think it was my first VHS tape, and it was...
Wait.
What?
VHS.
Yes.
Some people are watching right now have no idea what that is.
Okay, so for those of you who do not know what a VHS tape, stick a little tape in a box, and it played a movie for you, and there was no chapters, and...
I like how scientific this description of VHS is.
Box.
It's like, you stick it in a box, and people are like, wait, I don't understand how this even works.
It's rectangular. VCR.
Yeah, it's a VCR.
What does VCR stand for?
Video cassette recorder.
Oh, okay.
And VHS stands for?
Video...
Does anybody know what VHS is?
I don't think
video look, home if you know, system.
If you know what VHS stands for, just go ahead and drop it in the comments below. We're gonna move on. So what was the first movie?
It was Super Mario Brothers.
Are you serious? Super Mario Brothers. It's okay, so I don't know if she remembers what show we're on right now, but no, it's fine. No, Super Mario. I actually did like it when it first came out. Obviously, it doesn't hold up over time, but no. What did you like about Super Mario?
Well, it was kind of cool. I like that whole dimension, because when I was a kid, I was really into dinosaurs.
Okay.
And it was like a parallel universe where the dinosaurs really didn't die.
Well, that was kind of like the worst part of that concept of the movie.
But I feel like when you're 7 or 8, that concept is kind of cool.
I can see that.
And it was like some whole new parallel universe. And it was like, I loved the video game at the time. I was like, oh wow, they made a movie into like my favorite video game.
Well, see,
it was
that was
so
the reason,
awesome.
That was the reason why I liked it also, is because of the fact that it was like one of the first times, I don't know if you can hear the, it's raining outside right now.
Is that what that was?
Yeah, it's raining. But I don't know. So that was one of the things that we liked about it as a kid. It was the fact that they took something that we were playing every day and made it into a movie. But I mean, I don't know.
They do it all the time now.
Yeah. Now before it's... they didn't have that. You didn't have video games
like
turned into
Mortal
movies.
Kombat?
Right. Yeah. Mortal Kombat. The Man. First Mortal Kombat
Mortal
movie
Kombat.
Was dope.
Super.
Still doesn't hold up. But next movie.
I'm gonna have to go with Golden Child.
That's a nice pick.
Eddie Murphy, classic, hilarious, and everybody knows that I want the night.
Please.
Oh, was I supposed to be in sync?
And when the old man, the little old Asian man, dug his nose and wiped it on his.
So you just gonna put that on your shirt? Right there.
He said it was gonna freeze and scratch him later. Wow. Eddie Murphy used to do a really good job of doing films where it mixed seriousness and comedy
right. And
action, like all in one.
Right.
A lot of times you get comedy, maybe some action in a comedy, serious in action, but he had like the whole shebang.
Yeah. Okay, my movie, great pick. I have to acknowledge that first. My first movie is gonna be as nostalgic as you can possibly get. We're gonna go all the way back. To Never Ending Story.
Yes.
So if you grew up in the 80s or were born in the 80s, you probably saw it in the 90s, but you probably have seen it by now. The Never Ending Story is one of those fantasy movies that everybody could just watch and be like, man, I wish I could like do that, like read a book and then just be transported inside the book. But basically at the end of the movie, he was part of the story. He technically had been part of the story the whole time. He didn't even know it. So Atreyu, which was the warrior that the main character Bastion was following through the entire book, through the entire movie when he was reading the book, and he basically took him with him through the whole journey. And at the end, it was his choices that was able to save everybody. Now, there's a big debate online on whether or not Bastion was actually mentally unstable. Like the whole thing was just like a crazy episode.
Interesting. I didn't know about it.
It's actually kind of sad. I was like, it puts a whole new
childhood ruined.
Right, you know. I'll put that up right there. Childhood ruined hashtag. Yeah, I when I read that article, I was like, oh my God, that makes perfect sense. Because why would
he was troubled.
But right, he was a troubled kid. And
I mean, it makes sense because he had just lost his mom and yeah. And he had to like escape into a world to kind of, I guess, cope with that. So
yeah.
But I do like the Luck Dragon. That was a
Falcor.
Yeah. I did like Falcor.
Yeah. I love Luck. That was a good
so.
One.
What I never understood: what name did he give? Okay. The childlike empress.
It's see now.
Ashton, say my name. Right. So and, but when he says it, you can't understand. It's incoherent.
So yeah. Now the online, I looked this up. So online, somebody said that he said Mariah. I thought he said Mariah, but it's not Mariah. It's Moonchild.
I heard that theory too.
He opens up the window and says, Moonchild. And he like, he stretches it out. So it doesn't even make any sense. Plus there's like lightning and thunder and all this other stuff going on. So nobody, like for the years, everybody was like, it's like, sure, that's what his name is. Just incoherent screaming. That's just gonna save the universe. So what's your next pick?
Oh, it's back to me again?
Yes, it is.
Okay, I would have to say pick number two is Fern Gully.
Fern Gully. I like, yeah.
My name
is Betty. So
my logic is a rat.
Oh,
the only time you hear Robin Williams rap.
Yeah.
He's Robin, like one of my favorite, he was one of my favorite actors.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
Rest in peace.
Exactly. No, okay, so.
Can we do a video like favorite Robin Williams movies?
Maybe. We'll do that. Okay. Let's stay on topic this time. Okay. We're trying to stay on topic. I promise you, we're really trying to stay on topic. We were all over the place
in
the last video.
Okay,
we brought Nessie in from Express Your Geek, and she's pretty to the point. She's not.
All right, Fern Gully. So what do you like about Fern Gully?
What do you like
about
Fern
Gully? Like the rainforest, and it was like fairies, and it was like so cool. And then I kind of like the songs that they sang. It was kind of, it was very 90s. The songs,
and it had Tone Loc. I think any movie that came out in the 90s that didn't have Tone Loc in it was probably garbage.
Right, Blank Check, also movie. Bay Bay's Kids.
What's the one with Ace Ventura?
Oh, right.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so if it didn't have Tone Loc, we didn't, no, we're good. Mm-mm. We're good. No, it's the 90s. We need Tone Loc. The
cool Salamander.
Tone Loc. It was Tone Loc playing Tone Loc as a salamander.
Never has any other names in anything he plays.
Right.
He's like, always Sinbad.
Yeah. First Kid, that was another good movie.
Yeah, so is that all you liked about Fern Gully?
Well, see, I liked Tim Curry's part because, for one, every good villain is going to have a vaguely British accent, and Tim Curry is perfect at playing the perfect villain. Right. So the song, when he actually took over the big... The tree killer thing?
Yeah, yeah.
When it was like, oil and grime, toxic rain, pouring down like egg chow mein.
Slime beneath it,
slime up above. Oh, you love my toxic love. Yeah,
that was the jam.
Yeah, for some reason I could watch that over and over again and not get tired.
I thought I was the only one that loved that song.
Yeah, and see,
that's hilarious.
And it was a lot of good points in Fern Gully because it wasn't like a Disney movie, and it was a cartoon, which was amazing that it actually did any kind of money, any kind of profits, because it wasn't Disney. And everybody's like, wait, oh, this wasn't Disney? If you ask anybody who made Fern Gully, everybody would be like, oh yeah, that was Disney. It's like, nope, it wasn't.
Yeah, you're right. Now that I think of it, it kind of had that Disney-ish feel, but it wasn't Disney.
It was just off a little bit to not be Disney, because there were no dead parents. They didn't kill off they didn't kill everybody. It was like the parents didn't get killed off immediately, like at the very beginning. Like, okay, character development, kill the parents. All right, so what was your next pick?
My next pick would be Lean On Me.
Lean On Me.
Lean On
Me. Okay, we're taking a bit of a turn. We went cartoons and now we're going to more drama.
So typically I'm a fantasy kind of girl. But if we're talking about nostalgic movies, Lean On Me gotta be in there.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, you gotta be in.
You know, and see, we know each other from way back, if you don't know. that's kind of an understatement. But, so, our favorite character was actually the one we made fun of the most, who the looked girl? Like a roach.
The bad lady.
I want to apologize to the name? Actress that plays this character, but you look like a roach in this movie.
What character is that?
What is her name?
I don't know her name.
She was the one who said it first.
Way but back. She was the bad lady.
You mean yeah.
the one that was trying to.
One that played in Where in the World is Carmen San
Diego? Yes, her.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was her name?
If you know her name, put it in the comments below, and we'll discuss it later, and maybe in the next video. We'll give you credit for it in the next video.
That's the lady from Where in the World. How do you not? I mean, she did get on my nerves in that movie.
Yeah.
But
she was just bad. It was messed up.
Yeah, she was. I mean, he was just
We don't want a good teacher. We want Mr. Clark.
You don't know a thing about Mr. Clark. Mr. Clark been a father to some of us who they never had father. Wait a minute, but we can't do Lean On Me without singing the song
Fairy Side. I don't know the rest.
Where he came in the bathroom and he thought he was really gonna bust them, and then they start singing on key.
Right. And he was like,
in them harmonies.
And he was like, all right then.
He pulled Sam into the music room and slammed him into the piano. Miss Levias, who's responsible for this song? She all scared, thinks she about to lose her job.
Right.
Yeah.
She was just as well.
That was a good movie. That was a great movie.
That was pretty good. That was pretty good. And Morgan Freeman didn't look as old in this one.
But
that's a challenge. Find me a picture or a movie of Morgan Freeman pre-gray.
Freeman young.
Which poses the question of how old is he really?
He's never been young.
He's a vampire like for real.
Maybe he is.
Pharrell is a vampire. See, I knew it. I had a theory that Pharrell was a vampire, and so was Will Smith, but that's okay.
No, Will Smith starts to look aging.
Yeah, he started. Did you see
that? If you look at his Instagrams,
yeah.
He looks like he's aging.
There's even a picture where he's like he's bungee jumping, and he looks
Uncle Phil.
Yeah, Uncle Phil.
I remember that. I saw that.
And yeah, he's definitely human. Pharrell, that's debatable.
Yeah, we're on to you, Pharrell.
I've been thinking that for a while now.
Okay. Alright, so what's your next pick?
My next pick. Okay, this is hard because I don't want to step on anybody's toes, so I don't want to say anything. So I have one that many people probably don't know about because it was actually I think it started out as a parody of an actual toy line, and it became its own thing. So Garbage Pail Kids was my pick because they had these gross little cars.
It was extremely gross.
It was so nasty.
I remember I wasn't allowed to watch it. My mom was like, you're not watching them nasty.
Have you never seen Garbage Pail Kids?
I mean, no, because my mom was like, you're not watching them nasty kids.
I mean, she was not wrong.
Man, that movie was disgusting.
Yeah.
That reminds me, I know my next pick.
Okay.
So I like Garbage Pail Kids because of the fact that the nostalgia factor, obviously. And if I watched it now, I'm sure it doesn't hold up because all of it was like this weird animatronic. Because it was, this is gonna sound messed up, but they had like little people in costume for all the long shots. It was basically puppets and stuff. But they had humongous heads. Like
they were like, they were a parody of Cabbage Patch Kids.
Did I say that?
What toy line?
Yeah, Cabbage Patch Kids. They were
probably.
But they came out with all these different cards, and it was so many.
It was almost trading cards.
Yeah, and it was almost like a Mad Magazine. It was almost like the same artist from Mad Magazine. They took the weirdest concept they can and just made that into a character, and they put most of those characters into this movie, which was so weird. They had an alternate universe inside of a trash can. It was just the weirdest
thing.
Didn't
they have like some kind of weird fashion show at the end of the
Yes,
movie?
They did.
Wow, I'm really surprised you remember
that. That was like, it was so awkward. But it was a great movie.
Was it really though?
No, it wasn't. Okay. It wasn't.
It's just
it was nostalgic.
I think it's the fact that they're not like geeky and gross. Right. It was like kids farting, because you know fart jokes when you were a kid are like totally hilarious.
Right, because there was one scene where they
if done correctly.
They were farting. One character farted and it blew everybody. It was like wind. Everybody's holding onto the thing like ah. It was so crazy. It was like I'm like yeah, this is probably
not. I don't know why that was so funny to me.
I can see why my mom didn't let me watch that show or that movie.
It probably wasn't the best movie to be watching as a kid.
Oh man, fart bombs. Yeah.
Yes. What's my next one? Space Jam?
Space Jam?
I'm not gonna yuck her yum.
Yes, I remember. When I was a kid, like that was the movie that they always played. Remember when they had like the little TV AV thing, and the teacher was like, "Oh, it's raining outside. You can't go out for recess. Let's put in Space Jam."
We might have to pull your nostalgia 80s.
What's wrong with Space Jam? It's 90s.
It's not even close to the 80s. I think they came out in like 2000 or something like that.
It came out in like the 90s.
Like late 90s.
Well, still my childhood.
What part of, you mean like child in heart?
No, I meant like, I was like, I think I was in middle school or something.
Middle school, is that middle school, I guess?
So. No, I was in middle school and I remember, and it had like Michael Jordan when he was at the height of his career. Like, I mean, it was cool because for one, it had Michael Jordan back when the Bulls were like ruling the world. Like everybody, the Scottie Pippen.
Do you even like basketball though?
No.
So why does that even matter?
But everybody had the little jersey, the 23 jersey. That was the style.
You right.
That was the style. Everybody had the little jacket. Right. Everybody had the Chicago Bulls starter jacket.
The fact that he was. So who's your favorite character? Who's your favorite Space Jam character?
First, I gotta give a shout out to NBA Jam that I used to play. Remember that video game, NBA Jam, with the head on it? But anyway, I digress. I wanted to say my favorite character.
Let's switch topics. Go ahead.
Yes, that's what I do. And I wanted to say my favorite character, obviously, would be Bugs Bunny.
Okay, so when we did Tiny Toons, my favorite character is Babs Bunny. Like, dude, I don't want to be cliche, but let's do it again.
Okay. I must love like bunny characters or something.
And I told her last time I wasn't gonna bunny shame her, but I'm bunny shaming you this time. There was so many better characters.
Well, I could have said Lala, what was her name?
Lola.
What
is her name?
Well, because she wasn't my favorite character, so I didn't know her name.
Well, okay, so did you have a favorite character in Space Jam?
Nope.
You did not. I like the Monstars. They just were cool to me. I like the designs of them and anything like that. But anyway, we're gonna move on.
So I'm gonna take it back to.
Please do.
You gotta get excited about this.
Okay.
You ready?
Yes.
Ooh, I'm ready too. Howard the Duck.
Oh!
Ah, yes!
Okay, so I'm gonna reveal a little bit. This is a little bit behind the scenes. We kind of talked about a little bit what we wanted to talk about for
this
video.
We did not say Howard.
She did not tell me she was gonna bring up Howard the Duck.
Well, you made me think of Howard, because remember back then, graphics and all that stuff was pretty much non-existent.
Yeah.
So when I'm thinking about how Garbage Pail Kids looked, it reminded me that's exactly what Howard the Duck looked. He didn't look nothing like a duck. He was just like this hard plastic beak. That's what he was. A hard plastic beak.
But Howard the Duck.
They had a relationship with a human woman.
Yes. It was a lot of bestiality going on in that movie.
What is
why would we hear that?
This is a little extra. Remember how they like he opened a wallet and just like a little ducky condom in there?
No. I don't remember this.
Listen, yes, that was like a little ducky condom. Why am I whispering?
I don't know.
No, they like apparently actually got busy in that movie because they like fade out.
Yeah, they fade out.
Why were we watching that?
She was like, what would he say? Like, you never know love until you love the duck or something?
Right. Like, it was like a silhouette of the...
She legit, I mean, but it's alien duck.
I mean, was she really at a point in her life that...
Man, look. She had it bad.
I mean...
Ooh,
I mean,
think she was a cocktail waitress. Hey, leave her alone.
I thought they were like into music or something.
She was in music.
She was a musician. Because at the end, they did the Howard the Duck song.
Like,
he was playing the guitar.
Right.
And then,
all into it, too.
Nonetheless, it was a great movie.
Good movie.
What was it?
Yeah, you're right.
Was it a good movie though?
You're right.
What
was again, I agree. Was it great?
Was it
great? How was the nostalgic?
Was it though?
It really, I feel like the movies that we like weren't really great, but
they were great at the time.
They were for us. Yeah, they were awesome.
We know me was great.
It was great.
But no, I was and Never Ending Story was great also.
And you know, honestly, after talking to you guys, it's funny because I think I just changed my next pick altogether just because of the nostalgia. It made me, Power to Dust jogged a whole bunch of memories. Of
I know it did too, because I got
movies.
One too now. I got one too.
Yeah,
now.
Okay, so who's next? Who's it me?
It's you.
All right, so I don't know if anybody remembers this. It was a Disney movie. It was live action. It was, I want to say...
The Mighty Ducks?
No.
I thought we were going with a duck.
It was a duck theme just because you said... No. What was it? Flight of the Navigator.
Oh, yes! I love that movie.
Okay, so you got that look. Okay, let me explain what the movie was. Okay, so it took place in like the 80s or whatever the case is, and the main character, I can't remember his name to save my life, but if you remember, David? Was it Dave?
I think it was David.
Oh, yeah, it was David because the ship kept saying David. Okay, mm-hmm. So what happened was he ended up going to this area where he shouldn't have gone into, and he ended up getting into this ship.
Was it? It had that little,
the little alien thing, and it looked like
crystal shaped or something.
Yeah.
The ship looked crystal shaped.
Yeah, I remember that.
It looked like a big almond, but when it went
I remember that.
It traveled through time, and he got stuck in the future, and like his older brother his younger brother was like much older in his 20s, and everybody, they had been looking for him for the last 15 years and everything. And so when the government found out, just like E.T. and all these other movies, the government found out, they were like, all right, we got to get the ship and we got to get this kid and figure out, you know, what is going on and how he was able to travel through time. But the whole thing was he bonded with the ship. It's so good. Mm-hmm. So good and great. Mm-hmm. Good. That's a new word. That's a new word. So. Ashley, let's do another one.
Okay, it's back to me. Okay, I have one in mind, but now I got a new one. And then, because it kind of reminds me when we said animatronics.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to say...
That opened a whole bunch of doors.
I know, right? So, mine was Little Shop of Horror.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
That's a great one. I love that movie.
Yeah.
That's a great one. That was a really good one. My favorite part, which is probably one of the most random parts, but not really, I guess. But when they're singing Suddenly Seymour and they go into what they want their lives to be like, and it's all cute and picket fence and nice, because Skid Row was all dirty and nasty and stuff all the time. So when they went to that part, I was like, oh, they could really have it. Like, and then they had the two little kids and
they look just like
them. Funny thing.
Playing Howdy Doody. That's the part I
was like, Suddenly Seymour.
She had the most salacious lisp in life.
She's like, Seymour, I love you, but we can't be together.
You had just a little bit too much bass for her.
But she was.
Her voice was extremely high pitched, and she had a ridiculous lisp.
She did.
Off topic, but on topic, whoever created the word lisp? It's cruel.
Oh, yeah.
Because you can't say it if you have it.
If you have a list,
I didn't even think about it, but you're like,
I got a list.
I got a list.
That's probably one of my favorite parts of that movie.
Our lexicon is so good. I think my favorite part of that movie has got to be Audrey.
When they were singing.
And they were singing. No, not Skid Row. That's your
favorite.
No.
That's my other favorite part.
Down on Skid. Yeah.
Right. Down on Skid. He's singing so hard.
I know. It was the only one singing his heart out. Like, I believe I'm gonna get my
heart out. Right. This is gonna be my breakout moment.
Right. And we never saw him again. Whoever the actor is, I'm sorry, but you didn't get anywhere.
We gonna go back and watch it, and he gonna mess around.
Somebody big.
Right. We just never noticed.
That was Brad Pitt the whole time. Had no clue.
I'm pretty sure
that's not gonna happen.
I'm pretty sure you're right.
But I liked when he was he was trying to convince to come downstairs. Was it? No, not convince somebody to come downstairs. He was trying to convince Seymour to kill the doctor.
Oh, okay.
He was like, it's supper time. Right.
Oh, when he was singing that song.
Right. And he was,
Is that it?
What's it for? How's it open up, though?
I don't remember.
He's got your number now. Or something like that.
I just remember the girls, eventually the girls came in and were singing in the background.
Yeah, they were like the Greek chorus of the movie.
Yeah.
It was so creepy because I was like, oh, this is about to go down. He's like, oh, no. I was like, no.
He
ate the mess out of him.
I mean, it was like, I loved the movie, but I was kind of scared of it at the same time.
Why'd you have to whisper that part?
I don't know.
That made it even worse.
I know. But I didn't know that the guy that sang it was the dude from The Temptations. One of the guys from The Temptations. Yeah. I was like, oh, wow.
Wait.
So I'm going to go back to my fantasy group.
Okay.
Okay. And say Willow.
Willow was a good one.
Now, the strange thing about it is that all I remember is that I really liked watching it. Is that A, I really liked it. And B, the little guy was trying to save the baby, who was like a chosen child, from an evil woman. I guess would be
I'm starting to see a theme here. I think you like where it's like somebody trying to save someone else, like Lean On Me, Joe Clark was trying to save the school. We got Golden Child, Eddie Murphy was trying to save the Golden Child.
Another child trying to be saved.
And then Willow's trying to save the baby, the child.
I must like children.
I do. That's what I do for a living.
Oh. Mm-hmm. I thought it was Expression Geek that you do for a living. Anyway,
I guess that would be my living once I see a child.
All right. Right. Hey, guys. Just support Expression Geek. Because we want to start paying this one over here. So, yeah. Like and subscribe. Expression Geek. You know, as a matter of fact, we're going to pause right now for you. So, just hit pause. Run over to Express Your Geek. Just go right up there to the search. Search Express Your Geek, all one word, or
is
separate.
Is it up there?
You can do it. Yeah, it's up there. You don't see it? It's right there.
Oh, it's in the cloud.
Yeah, right there. Okay, so when you search it, just search for it. And then when you go to it, like the first video that's there, subscribe, and then like hit that bell so you can get notifications for Express Your Geek so you can see more of this one over here. But outside of that, we're going to go back to the video. That was just shameless plug there.
Willow.
I like the fact that Val Kilmer.
Oh, that nickname, Will?
No. Val Kilmer was dope in this. He was a cool Mad Mardigan. He played the swordsman that was like kind of almost like a Ronin if you wanted to switch it over to like Japanese times. He was like a warrior without country. He was disgraced, and his whole backstory was kind of convoluted a little bit.
About Ronin from Stargate Atlantis.
See, I didn't watch that.
Oh, goodness.
I'm not that much of a geek. Oh, yes, I am. But anyway, yeah.
Now, I have a question. Is that where they kind of like not perfected, but kind of first started using like morphing?
Yes, as a matter of fact, they, believe it or not, and this is a little fact, and that's good that you knew that. So in that movie,
I know a little stuff,
in that
Joe.
Movie, they actually created the technology for morphing one thing into another thing. So they had the actual Good Witch had morphed into a bird, a llama, a tiger at one point, a mouse, it was one mouse, and then back into a woman again. And it was crazy because no other movie had ever done that. And it was done really well. Now, obviously it doesn't hold up if you watch it now, but yeah.
For its time.
Right,
really...
don't hit pause and go watch it and be like, Joe, what was that? You're like, but it was early technology.
When did that movie come out?
It came out a long time ago. Yeah. That's an actual date.
Oh.
So you can look that up. that was a good movie. I liked it, and I like one of my favorite, the little pygmy characters were the like really cool. It's like, yeah, and they were like had the little spears and stuff. They're like this big.
Oh yeah. Oh, I forgot about that. That was really good.
To watch that movie.
I'm
about
really to go rewatch.
It's a really good movie. You said it was a good movie. It was good.
It was great.
It was good. Next pick.
It's you.
It's me?
It's you.
Oh, okay. Then I choose Labyrinth.
Great. That's a good movie.
You can't go wrong with David Bowie.
I was just gonna say that.
David Bowie in a movie. He plays the Goblin King.
And he sings.
And there's Muppets, and not like puppets. No, these are Muppets. This was a Jim Henson thing.
Yep.
They were Muppets, official Muppets. When you look at any of the like the big Muppet movies where they have like all the Muppets, like Sesame Street and all that, they throw in a couple of goblins from the Labyrinth. And I'm like, that's dope. Because, you know, people don't like to, they don't know that those are all the same thing. But yeah, Jim Henson did his thing with Labyrinth. And
the movie was also creepy.
The movie was creepy. Although our favorite part was
when they were taking their
heads
off.
Yeah, when they take the heads off.
Juggling
Chili Down with the
And that's a great song.
Chili Down with the bugger. I don't know what they're called. Think Small, Think Small with the
drum. Yeah.
Our other favorite song is the dance.
What kind of
magic spell do you use?
Snakes,
slimes, or snails, or puppy dog's tails,
yeah.
Thunder or lightning.
Dance, magic,
dance, magic, dance, dance, magic. Put that baby spell on you.
I always skip straight to the part where it says slap.
Jump,
baby,
magic, jump, magic, jump. Like the little
True.
Worm.
It's yes, like, I like that little.
Would you like
worm.
To come in and have a cup of tea?
And then it's like,
oh no, don't go that way. Don't ever go that way.
And she didn't ask her. And she was like, oh, thanks. And she turns around and goes, oh, if he had gone that, if she had gone that way, she'd gone straight to that castle. Which is where she was trying to go in the first place.
It's like, oh, man. It's like, ah!
It's like, why didn't you just listen to the whole story? Yeah, but that was actually what the moral of that movie was. It was taking things for granted. She just took it for granted that he was trying to lead her to the castle. Like, why would you think that? He didn't know where she was trying to go.
Right.
If she had said, oh, hey, I'm trying to go to the castle. Oh, well, then go that way.
Right.
And it would have been the end of the movie. That movie would have been like 5 minutes long.
He didn't even know where she was trying to go. So why would she just blindly take his advice?
That was the point. And throughout the entire movie, that was the Goblin King's point to try to teach her, was the fact that she had been taking things for granted the entire movie. She had just basically been assuming things without really knowing what was going on. And it was like, you know, you need to learn this lesson. Obviously, he was doing it because he was in love with her and all this other extra stuff, which, you know, it's funny that this was actually, the whole movie was a love story. It was like, it was not a romantic comedy, but it was like a romantic adventure or something like that. Because the Goblin King was in love with the main character.
Right.
And he only took the baby because she, right. No. She asked him to.
Oh, that's right. She did the little thing.
Yeah.
She was like, so mad that she had the babysit.
Right. She was like, Goblin King. And the goblins in the mirror is like, that's not even how, it doesn't even start with, I want you to take the baby. It's like, did she say it? Shut up. Everybody's like, shh. But anyway, but yeah, he even explains it to her at the end. He's like, I did everything you asked. I gave you an adventure, I took away the baby so you can have your time, and you still don't love me. Like, what's going on? Like, I did everything. And she was like, oh, I need you to bring my brother back, because I was just kidding.
I was just playing, like, though. I wasn't for real.
Right, and he's like, what? You just assumed that, okay, fine.
Just because I did a magic spell to take him away don't mean I really want him to go away.
Right, you know, it's like, yeah, what are you thinking? Who does that? You know? But yeah, it was a great movie. I love the Escher maze at the very end, the M.C. Escher. Anyway, there's an Escher painting where it's like stairs to go up this way, stairs to go this way. And the whole last part of the movie was like that. And it was like, there's one scene where David Bowie's character comes up from the underside. And I was like, that was a cool special effect that they did. Cause he was up here and she was down there, and then they were opposite places. She got to a landing, and he just came up like that. I was like, whoa, that was really dope. But yeah, the whole movie was good. And the bog, the eternal stench. And Hobo.
I like it.
Hobo, not Hobo.
Oh man, y'all must really love this movie.
I just realized, we've been talking this whole time. You've never seen it, have you?
I mean, not past the first 10 minutes, no.
Really?
Oh my God, your card has been pulled.
What card, though?
The 80s nostalgia.
Okay.
Like, I was kind of wondering, like, what card is it?
It's been revoked.
I mean, which card is getting revoked?
Yeah. It's like, you're going through, it's like, which one?
We have a plethora of cards.
It's like, this one? Oh, the 80s.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah.
It's like a punch card. It's like, can you take back a punch? Never mind. So,
can we all just agree on this last one?
Okay, what's the last
one? Okay, what's the last one?
Barry Gordy's Last Dragon.
Barry Gordy's The Last Dragon. Bruce Leroy.
You look like you don't want to agree with
Oh
that.
My
I'm
goodness.
Looking like I've never seen it.
Oh no.
That's the look of, I don't know what y'all talking about.
Are you serious?
Yes.
We need to stop and just watch the movie now.
Yeah. I can just quote the whole movie to everyone if you want. You got an hour
I'll
and
just
half?
Watch you then. I'm like, my popcorn.
Man, I can't believe you've never it starts seen off. It. It's the best.
Dun it, dun it, dun it.
I'm definitely not getting my car back now, am I?
You are the last track.
Yeah, we are here. That's like two cards revoked. That
the glow. I'm never, just like.
The glow.
I'm gonna take classes. I'm gonna take like you any different styles of classes to get my card back.
Who's the master?
Show enough.
Who's the master?
Show enough.
Who's the master?
I'm guessing show enough.
I can't believe you've never seen no, Mary yeah. the Last Dragon.
Just deliver your pizza to Daddy Green's pizza.
I mean, is it one of those things like I've never seen it because I've never seen it and it's like a bad thing, or y'all seen it because y'all live in the same house?
Oh, No.
Everybody watching this video, you'll know what we're talking yes. about. And unfortunately, yes. I feel bad to say this, but you're out of the loop on this one. Because
yeah.
it's a universal thing.
All right. Let's try to give her a pass and give her another chance.
Okay.
What about?
I'm ready. Let's do
what
this.
What about?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
I'm gonna get you sucker.
Oh!
No.
Oh, what?
Oh, man! What?
Not only do I have to get my 90s card up, I gotta get my black card
you
up.
You do! You do!
Let me just get my cards right now.
Actually, being hurt my heart.
Let me just get these cards out. Here you go. Here's my black card. Here's my 90s card.
I'm coming home for you,
Elizabeth. Here's my 90s catchphrase card.
I can't believe you've never seen The Last Dragon. And I'm going to get
it's either color. One or the other. You can't, like, not see both.
I've seen Color Purple.
Let's talk about when it actually does know.
Yes.
How back about, to the Future.
Back to the Future. I
yes,
know you
I
know,
do,
back
I know
to
that.
Future.
I know that one. I know that one.
Part four.
There's no one. I was like, oh, no, there's no part four. So, yeah, y'all tried to get me with that
was
trick.
A test. That was a test. It's like, yeah, I have seen that. I have seen that one. No, you haven't. It doesn't exist. Okay. But, you know, two is my favorite because, you know, I'm a futurist. I like future stuff.
Yeah,
to the Future part one and two are my favorites. Part three can go away.
It's a trilogy. You gotta take them all.
You do have to, but you don't want to.
I always get them mixed up in which order they happen in.
Well, you go back to the future, you go forward to the past, and you go all the way to the Western time.
Okay, yeah. The Western three. How was not the one to like.
Understand?
The third is the Western one.
Three is the one I like the least.
Yeah,
well,
I think
everybody can agree.
Nobody likes the Western one. Sorry, Marty McFly and Doc Brown, but those aren't the ones we like.
I do say that the second one is my favorite one because
it just looks the coolest.
That and the fact that they go back in the first movie in the second movie. Like when he
that was so meta. The cool thing about Back to the Future and that one specifically is when they went back into their own movie, that like blew my mind, because I think that was the first time in any movie that anybody had ever done.
I think
that.
You're right.
Where they're like, okay, there's a trilogy of movies and a character goes back in time and sees himself acting in the movie that he was just in.
Yeah.
That
remember, like, he was in the car and he saw it, like, he was trying to duck down, so he wouldn't get caught by himself and his mom in the car in the first movie. Yeah,
that was good. That was a good part.
Back to the Future is great.
Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and end it on that. I'm sure you have not watched this entire video, and hopefully you have though, because we're going on so many tangents, but at least we had Nessie here from Express Your Geek to keep us on task, and I appreciate you being on the show today.
I appreciate it.
It's like you need somebody to keep me on task or something.
This one over here. Literally, we're talking about movies. I like NBA Jam. That's a video game.
Well, they both had jam in it.
And she just got us on.
Hey, I'm ending the video and she got me off topic. Talking about, I don't get people off topic.
It's my superpower.
This one over here. Obviously, Ashley B, everybody already knows her from the previous video, so I want to thank you for being on the episode
well, thank you for having me.
Again. Hopefully we can do this once again. Stay tuned for the next episode, which we will probably be on so many tangents you won't know what the topic is. And also catch Nessie over at Express Your Geek. Channel is up and live, and we are having a contest on Express Your Geek. I don't know if you want to tell anybody about it. Well, we'll go into the contest. Go over to Express Your Geek and find out what the contest is. We're giving some stuff away, and it's not just like some rinky dink stuff.
It's not
pretty
a t-shirt.
Cool. Yeah, it's not
it's
like
something that you really would like.
Right. It's
t-shirts
not like an Express
cool.
Your Geek t-shirt. Although
they can.
Yeah, they can be.
But you know, people like real.
Yeah.
Real.
You know, like cool stuff. I mean, t-shirts are good. Hats are good. I promise it's not a t-shirt and a hat. Like, oh, it's not a t-shirt. It's a t-shirt and a hat. Uh-huh. No, it's some really cool stuff. So yeah, go ahead and check out the channel. Check out Nessie. The next episode is going to be about, what is it episode about?
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter. Okay, so I am Ravenclaw. What are you?
Ravenclaw.
Sweet, Ravenclaw. High five.
What are you?
Aries.
Ashley, what Harry Potter house do you reside in?
The kind that you live in.
Oh my goodness. On that note, we're gonna end it here. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next episode. I'll see you. The camera's like way too far. I can't do the thing, but I'm gonna try to do it.
Like, oh. Bye, guys.